Mr. Subedar, Sanjay Bhatia Sahab, Neol Tata Ji, Pranab Das Kumar Sahab, Dr. Malini Shankar, Anil, my seniors, captains of the industry, and friends. Very good morning, and it's a great privilege to be here with you all. And topic given to me is containerization. As I've introduction has been given, I come from income tax. So 3 years back, before joining shipping sector, whenever I used to look container, I used to look at the prosperity of industry, how much tax some industry will pay, that's all. So container was a box. I joined JNPT in 2014, and every day my respect for this box has increased. Layer after layer, if you go into history, it's an amazing product, innovation, out-of-box idea, a disruptive thought process. Today we call it out-of-box. Everybody's searching how to streamline the processes, find out something out-of-box. This container is the biggest out-of-box idea which has transformed this sector. We are sitting in Bombay Port Trust. If you look at old ports, the workforce will be 30,000, 40,000 people working in the payrolls of the port. Kindly imagine what kind of workforce was there and what kind of work used to happen. It was happening primarily because of absence of a box. Mr. Malcolm invented this box in 1956, a steel box which did away with this requirement of warehouses. It moved to a unitized cargo, mechanized ports. If you see the history, since 1956, more and more container terminals have come up instead of bulk cargo terminals, which used to happen earlier. This has transformed in the sense of economic value. Per ton cost used to be around $5.50. After containers, it came down to $0.50 per ton. So that there's a transformation which has happened. So this box has eaten away dry bulk cargo ports. So people stopped creating those kind of bigger ports, moved to container terminals. So that's the most disruptive idea. Mr. Tata was talking about containerization and number he talked about. If you look at globally, probably the entire container volume is more than 600 million TEUs. And Indian share is will be touching 14 million this year, minuscule. And if you look at, so containerization has not penetrated deeply into Indian system. If you look at the analysis of Indian ports, I think 4 or 5 ports will be constituting around 80% of container volume. So somewhere, that's where we are lacking, that the economic benefit of containerization, which must have come to the industry, to a common man, has not been realized fully in India. Major reasons which I look at after serving in port for 3.5 years, probably the great idea has been twisted and which led to multiple shifting, handling, unproductive detention, multiple stakeholders, leading to taking away the economic benefit which this containerization might have created for the Indian society and the trade. So somewhere that's a big challenge, that how we can increase this container number, because entire India's container volume is 14 million TEUs, and if you look at the Shanghai port alone, that's 35 million TEUs. And China has around 8 ports which have volume of 10 million plus. So probably a single port in China is doing more than double the volume of entire India as well as the containers are concerned. Long way to go, and probably that's the responsibility on all of us. So a great reform came somewhere after World War II, that containers came, economic benefit came up, but now I think a new generation reforms are required, where we further economize the operations in containers. The biggest challenge is that there's a multiple shiftings, multiple handlings, and unproductive detention, how we can reduce these three. If we reduce three, reduce any of these components, it can be a huge game changer for the Indian industry. If you look at globally, the biggest problem is happening, the challenges which are there, that empty movement is a big problem. So the container belong to a shipping line, it has to be returned. So how to deal with this? So trade is paying double the cost of returning the container back. It's happening in the hinterland, and second problem comes even globally. You are shifting these empty containers from one continent to another continent, adds to the cost. Transshipment, which could be good for shipping line to economize their operation, but it's not good for the industry because ultimately it's a cost, a container going to Colombo and then coming to India. So ultimately Indian industry is not getting the benefit of this containerization. So these areas needs to be looked into if we want to enjoy the full potential of containerization. Few steps we have taken in JNPT, if you are chasing JNPT or reading about JNPT, to increase this containerization. First is that how we can increase the capacity, because on the west front, there is a huge demand for container terminals. So fourth container terminals comes up, PSA is commencing his work. Honorable Prime Minister will be inaugurating this project on Sunday, adding a 2.4 million TEUs capacity in the port. So all of a sudden, a 14 million annual volume, and you are adding 2.4 million, almost 20% of the enhanced capacity comes into the system. This enhanced capacity, again, propels a lot of other initiative. So you have to be more competitive, it will bring more efficiency, so more benefit for the industry. The supply becomes more than the demand. It creates a new churning. Thirdly, it comes into Maharashtra. After a long time, a new capacity addition project comes up. On the entire West Coast, it creates a new churning of business. So all win-win situation for terminal as far as the trade is concerned. A biggest problem in containerization is it's a size. It's a 20-foot container. So if your cargo is less than 20-foot container, there's a problem. There comes a lot of issues. There's stuffing, de-stuffing issues come up. And the study suggests less than container load has a double or three times the cost of a full container load logistic cost. While all operations remain the same, but somehow everything is jacked up, it goes to two times or three times the normal logistic cost. So somewhere cargo aggregation is a challenge in India. We are dominated by a small scale industry. So small scale industry doesn't have that kind of cargo which can be exported in routine. So either it has to keep on aggregating the cargo and then they send a container, full container load, or a stuffing happens. Our land holding is less, so agro-produce export again becomes a challenge. So somewhere cargo aggregation centers are required. Along with that, just-in-time delivery. If you compare this shipping line vis-a-vis courier service, the difference you can understand. In a courier, you can send a letter and also a box. Both the courier company will do it. That's why it's so fast. But container is a limitation because it has to be box full. Only then it makes the economic sense. So JNPT is trying to set up four dry ports in the Maharashtra. So that serves that purpose of just-in-time delivery of the cargo by the exporter and then the shipment. So it's a last-mile connectivity issue is taken care of. Cargo aggregation is taken care of, just in time arrival of cargo happens. SEZ, you might be reading that we are going full flow in selling our SEZ project. We look at this manufacturing needs a huge push so that the export from India moves up. In JNPT, we have started two new initiatives. One is direct port delivery and second is direct port entry. 78% of export is using direct port entry, which I normally say is a $60 model vis-a-vis $1 model. Earlier, the container used to go to a buffer yard where the 3,600 to 4,000 rupees was charges. Now we are doing all these processes along with custom department, and we are charging 60 rupees for 8 hours time. So we have replaced a $60 model with a $1 model. for 78% of the exports. Obviously, 22% exports are stuffing issue, so they have to go to the CFSs, buffer yards to get it done. DP, the new initiative where we are giving delivery from the terminal now, so it reduces the multiple handlings, and a truck can carry a container from the yard to the factory directly. To further streamline these processes, we are running a tender process. We are selecting one transporter. So this model probably will come up by the March end. The tenders are on, and it's a future Uber model for container terminals. So we are picking up a transporter for a particular route. So it goes a laden container. So earlier, it has to sit idle for 1 or 2 days to get the empty back. But if one operator is working on one route, idling will stop because it can pick up an empty container from some other client on the route and come back. If he can talk to the exporters, he can start picking up export on the way. So a laden container he takes into the hinterland, comes back as a laden container. Speaking to shipping lines, he can start repositioning empties. So this will be an optimum model for resource utilization. We do believe it can reduce the 30% trucks from the system. It can reduce tariff by at least 40%. So this process will be in operation by March end. I think we need support of the trade to carry it forward. Coastal, I think a lot of effort has been made in promoting coastal, but few missing links were there. As Bhatia Sahab was explaining, we are starting a new model where almost 4 lakh TUs we can move from JNPT to Bombay Port Trust through barges. The missing link was warehousing. Because of small economic benefit of warehousing, the cargo moved to wrong direction, Thane. If we can provide warehousing in the city, near the consumption center, probably we can take away these 4 lakh containers from the road, and that all start moving on the water. We are trying to create few more centers through which we can start this barge movement so that there are different centers of cargo aggregation from there through water. These containers start coming to the port. So globally, the two challenges which I look at in the containerization is that how we can reduce this less than container load dependency with 20-foot or 40-foot containers. If something can be done about that, it will be a great, great game changer. Then it will lead to us to a courier service kind of efficiency where smaller cargo, you can send it easily without depending upon other people joining you for stuffing happening. Second is how empty should be brought back. Can there be a collapsible containers? Somebody is running with these ideas that you can run 2 or 3 empty containers on same truck because it collapses, you can make it foldable containers. Third, why need this support from the trade is we have to reach out to the industry for promoting more and more cargo moving into containerization in India. Probably that exercise is missing. It's the industry which is driving. It's not stakeholders which are trying to drive it. We have to identify the industry which can be covered into this. We have to identify the items which can be converted into this. Unless we take it as a mission to increase the penetration of containerization, probably our industry will not reap the right benefits. So probably when I'm looking at the best brain sitting here, industry being represented, and all stakeholders know these all issues and the seriousness of government in promoting all this. I do believe today's conference will pave the way. We'll do the brainstorming, we'll find out new innovative ways that how containerization can be fully utilized and we can provide a great relief to the trade and the common man. Thanks a lot.